Before we take a trade in stock market, it is better to know the three different trading instruments available in the stock market. So basically, there are three trading instruments available in stock market. So equity, futures, and options. And it is better to know how these trading instruments works, and what are the different types of risk and reward available with these three trading instruments. So number one, equity offers less risk, and it gives less reward. Similarly with futures, it offers medium risk and the reward is also medium, whereas with options it offers high risk and the reward is also very high. If you are a beginner, even an intermediate level trader, I request to avoid both futures and options because the risk they carry. The idea of this module is to understand how these instruments work and how they offer different degrees of risk and reward. So we will take an example. For example, we will take an ACC example, and the current market price of ACC is 1620. We will check it on the charts. So for example, current market price of ACC is 1620. Assume a trading account has 1,75,000 rupees. So in this case, he can buy 108 shares of ACC. I will show it in the calculator. For example, if a person has 1,75,000 rupees, if the current market price is 1620, he can buy 108 shares, isn't it? So he can buy 108 shares. Now, just for the explanation sake, we will assume ACC has moved 5% upside on the next 2 days. This is just an assumption to understand how it works. So now the ACC price is 1701. The overall profit is 81 points, which is 5% move into 108 shares. So in this case, it comes around 8,748. So the profit is 8,748 and the capital of 1,75,000. So in this case, a return on investment on our capital is around 5%. So this is the case with equity. Now, we will check with futures. So basically, anyone can check the margins available with futures in their broker website. So this is a Zerodha margin calculator. So anyone can check with Google. So I will show it here. So basically what it tells is, with this much of capital, one person can buy this much of quantity. So here, one lot of ACC is 500 quantity. So this has been already predefined by the exchanges. And so what's in simple terms, with this much of amount, one can buy this much of quantity. So in our case, we had around 1,75,000 in our trading account. So automatically or simply, we can buy 500, means one lot of ACC. So now with this, with the same assumption, 5% move on the upside. So the what happens is the overall move is 81 points. So the total profit is around 40,500, which is 81 points into 500 shares. Do you remember one lot is 500 shares? So the profit is around 40,500 on our capital of 1,75,000. So the return on investment on capital is 53%. So it was around, just 5% in equity, but it shoots up to 53% in case of futures, okay? Similarly, we will check how it works with options. One can check with, basically before I explain this, I will say there are two types of options. One is call option, another one is put option. The simple, understanding is whenever the underlying price goes up, the premium of the call option also goes up. Similarly, whenever the underlying price goes down, the premium of the put option goes up. Okay, so it's a simple thing. Now, for this explanation sake, we will assume the same story. The 5% move happens in the next 2 days. So before that, assume anyone can check this information with NSND option chain. So I've taken ACC with a strike price of 1620. 1620 is the strike price because that is the current market price. So the two things is very important. So this is call option, this is put option. So I will explain only with the call options because we are talking about 5% move on the upside. As I said earlier, the premium of call option goes up, you know, if the underlying price moves upside. Similarly, the premium of put option goes up if the underlying price falls. So in this case, in this example, we are taking 5% move on the upside, right? So I will consider only the call options. So the two important things what we need to remember is LTP. So this is the price of this premium, 1620 CE price is this, and IV, so implied volatility. So what this indicates is if the, you know, price, underlying price ACC moves up, you know, it says the premium also moves up by 30%. That's what it says. Now, with the capital of 1,75,000, so with the 1,75,000 capital, you know, with the LTP, we can calculate how much you know a person can buy. See, for example, 1,75,000 is the capital. Now the premium is 30 rupees, so divided by 30. So he can buy 5833 quantity, you know, quantities of this premium. For example, 1620 CE. This might vary a little bit based on the, you know, quantity size, lot size, etc. But this, for explanation sake, we can assume he can buy 5833 because that is the, you know, exact division. Now we will assume the same story, the 5% move on the next 2 days. So the ACC price will be at 1701, 5% move. Then the same premium will move up by 30% of this move. Okay, so 30% of 81, which is around 24.3. So the premium new value will be at 54.3%, 54.3. But the profit is, you know, it's astonishing. We need to check the profits. So the profits is 24.3, 30% of this move into 5833. This is the total quantity we bought, you know, the call option. So which comes around 1,41,742. So in this case, return on investment on our capital is 81%. So in the first scenario with equity, we had around 5% ROI. So with futures, we had around 53% ROI, whereas with options, we have 81% ROI. So these are the, you know, this is how these three different trading instruments work. I will repeat once again, both futures and options carry high degree of risk. Your entire capital can be wiped out, if the trade goes against your direction. So if you're a beginner, I request to avoid these, you know, both futures and options. So the idea of this module is to understand or how to explain how, you know, these instruments offers with a different degree of risk and reward. Again, with options, you know, there are two types of trading. One is options buying, options selling. What I've explained is through with options buying. So there are different trading strategies. There are millions of trading strategies with option selling as well. However, I feel, you know, this much of basic understanding is enough for, you know, for a beginner. So I suggest a beginner should start with equities. So once he started making, you know, consistent return, he can try with futures, keeping money management in rule. So one person can think about, you know, trading in options only after making profits with capital. Again, by understanding the different degrees of risk available with options.